It's day 107 2016 and today we have a new device from you, a leak, a new VR headset from Huawei and an exchange program. All this and more in Phone Arena Daily. Let's begin. You has finally gone official with the Eureka Note, a 6-inch phablet that will cost you 13,500 rupees. It's got a 1080p screen, it's powered by a MediaTek MT6753T processor, has 3GB of RAM, has a 13-megapixel rear-facing camera and an 8-megapixel front-facing camera. And then you have, as with large phones, you have a large battery. It's got a 4000mAh battery and as I already said, it's going to cost you 13,500 rupees. So there is a new mid-range phablet at 6 inches and it's got a 1080p screen and whatnot. Has everything. It's going to compete with smaller phones for sure. So if you want to have more information about this phone, do check the story link below. A Moto G4 Plus has been spotted in the wild and this is supposed to sport a home button with a fingerprint sensor. Now this is a two-part leak. First was from EV Leaks and he showed off a simple image with the home button and then followed was the full image of the phone. So it basically shows off the whole phone and it has the same home button. So indeed the new generation Motos are coming and this is hopefully the Moto G4 Plus because earlier we had seen the Moto X which is supposed to sport a metal body. Now it'll be interesting to see if Motorola adopts the metal design language for this phone too, but we can't tell for sure now. So let's see when this arrives. Huawei jumped into mobile VR today by announcing their own first VR headset at an event in China. This is called the Huawei VR and it does look strikingly similar to the one from Samsung, the Gear VR. So it's pretty much the same, but the difference is that Huawei says it has a 360 degree sound field, which is a first on a mobile VR headset. So we're not sure what Huawei means by that. We can't see speakers, but maybe there is something. We'll check it out and possibly let you know. But this headset will work with Huawei phones like the P9. And it does have its own controls to switch between the modes or like the virtual reality and the augmented reality modes and so on. So it's pretty much similar to many of the VR headsets right now. And Huawei has packed a lot of content on this, a lot of panoramic content. So it will be pretty interesting to see where this goes from here. But nevertheless, Huawei has announced no pricing or availability details for now. OnePlus might be gearing for the OnePlus 3 sometime later, but right now it seems like they are at work on offers like this exchange offer for India. Basically, you can exchange your old phone for a new OnePlus smartphone and get discounts. The maximum discounts are up to 16,000 rupees and the eligible devices are the OnePlus 1, the OnePlus 2 and the OnePlus X. So basically all the OnePlus phones right now. What you have to do is note the order ID down after you have bought it from Amazon and then log into Amazon again and go into the mobile buyback offer. So that will take you to the ReGlow page, a company which OnePlus has partnered with for exchange and buyback programs, and enter your details. So basically you will be getting discounts based on your phone, the age of the phone, the working condition of the phone and so on. So that's up to them to decide how much of the discount they need to give you. But I think this is a pretty good thing that companies are offering, a lot of companies are offering them right now, and I want to base the point of discussion on this. How often do you exchange your phones and is exchanging the best form of recycling? What do you think? Let us know in the comment section below and that's about it for today's show. I'll see you later with more technology news. Thanks for watching.